السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم، أهنئكم بقدوم شهر مبارك، شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Give you all glad tidings, wish you all the best, congratulations for the month of Ramadan which has dawned upon us. As was the practice of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his Sahaba, that when the Hilal was sighted for the month of Ramadan and a few days before that, they would wish one another glad tidings for this month. As one of the scholars of the past, he said, أتى رمضان مزرعة للعباد لتطهير القلوب من الفساد فأدي حقوقه قولا وفعلا وزادك فاتخذه للمعاد. He said that the month of Ramadan has come upon you, a month of sowing the seeds of good deeds. أتى رمضان مزرعة للعباد لتطهير القلوب من الفساد, so that we can purify our hearts. فأدي حقوقه قولا وفعلا, and so give this month its right, its due in statement and in action. وزادك فاتخذه للمعاد, and so that your good deeds, your harvest, your reap, you take it to the hereafter. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this month of Ramadan, a month of blessing and a month which we make the best of it bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. We only have about 20 minutes, and so I thought, what do we speak about? Maybe a day in the life of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the month of Ramadan. What was his fast like? How would he begin his day? How would he spend his day? What was his salah like? So maybe 24 hours of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's day, we try to summarize it in 20 minutes, inshallah. That's a miracle on its own. Khair, inshallah. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would awake in the morning and it would be the time of suhoor. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السُّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. Wake up for the suhoor, for verily in it there is barakah. You have a banana, you have a few dates, you have a little bit of food, a bowl of cereal, and it keeps you going for the entire day. And we as South Africans make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the month of Ramadan has come upon us, and we in what? We in the season of winter, subhanallah. Begin fasting at 20 past 5. End your fasting 20 past 5. Ajib. Our brothers and sisters in London, in the UK, start fasting at 2:30 in the morning. End what time? End at 9:30. Salat al-Taraweeh begins at 11 p.m. Allahumma musta'an. So make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessing that we have. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would also state, ni'ma suhoor lil mu'min at-tamr, that the best thing that you could have for your suhoor is tamr, our dates. And we know, imagine this, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best man who walked the face of this earth. Outside of the month of Ramadan, he leaves his home at a time when people were all asleep, and he finds Abu Bakr and Umar on the street. What brought you people out of your homes? They said, nothing but hunger, Ya Rasulullah, out of Ramadan. And what brought you out, Ya Rasulullah? He says, nothing but hunger. And so eventually one of the other companions sees them and invites them to his house. Lack of better words, a half-dead goat was slaughtered and some dry bread they ate. After eating this, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, wallahi, we will have to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this ni'mah, this bounty that Allah has given us. What? Half-dead goat they had slaughtered and they had some dry bread. Imagine ourselves, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, how much of food we have at the time of suhoor and how much of food we have at the time of iftar. At a conference recently in Saudi Arabia, last year in Ramadan, we were invited, and so we were there, and there were some brothers from Malawi and brothers from Nigeria and all over the world, walhamdulillah, and brothers in places where they don't really see so much of food like this. And so at the time of iftar, this buffet, 20 dishes there, the guy's saying, are they trying to make a mockery of us or something? You know, we don't see food like this, and now they put so much. This is a fitna upon us. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam begin his fast at the time of suhoor. When the adhan of Salatul Fajr would go, that's the time that they would stop eating. And for example, in many a Muslim country up till today, because the adhan for Salatul Fajr is given at its earliest time, and so they stop eating at that time. If your local masjid gives the adhan later, you don't say, no, no, I'm going to continue eating until the adhan. No, the time of Salatul Fajr, that's when eating stops. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then what was his practice? And then he goes off to the masjid. He would pray his two rak'ahs of sunnah in his house. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's practice, all of his sunnah prayers in the house and the fara'id in the masjid. Enters the masjid, prays Salatul Fajr. He stated that rak'ati al-fajr khayrun min ad-dunya wa ma fiha. The two rak'ahs of Salatul Fajr are better than this world and whatever it contains. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, we might have the most beautiful of car, the most expensive of vehicle, but if it does not take us to the masjid, then what worth is it? Yes, we might say it's cold in the morning, but also the cold in Jahannam is even more severe. As the Prophet ﷺ, as in the Quran, it states that in Jahannam, there's the severity of heat and there's also the severity of cold. Prophet ﷺ sits in the masjid after Salatul Fajr. As was his practice, he would remain in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until the sun would rise. Then he would pray two rak'ahs of salah. What's the reward of praying these two rak'ahs of salah? Anyone? After Salatul Fajr, sitting, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, recitation of Quran, whatever dhikr you might make, just remembering Allah. And then you pray two rak'ahs, nafil salah after sunrise, you get the reward of a full hajj and the reward of a full umrah. Hadith reported by Imam At-Tirmidhi. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go back to his home, see to the family, and then the day begins. The day begins. You have people coming, questions being asked. What do we do in this situation? Judgment. He is the Qadi. He is the Mufti. He is Amirul Mu'mineen. He is the government. He is everything, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has a whole ummah to see to. And some of the incidents, Umar radiallahu ta'ala comes to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah, I put myself into a problem. What has happened, O Umar? Ya Rasulullah was fasting and I kissed my wife. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to him, made qiyas, said to him that don't you see if a person gargled their mouth, would there be any problem? He says, no, no problem. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, well, that's similar to this and so there's no problem. Another man comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has questions. He says, Ya Rasulullah, I have destroyed myself. What has put you into this destruction? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him. And then he says, I slept with my wife, fi nahari Ramadan. That's, you know, we were intimate with one another, full intimacy. What do I do? I've destroyed myself. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to him, and this is where we get the whole ruling of kafara from. This hadith reported by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim. And the man has come. He could have kept quiet. He could have sat in his house. Nobody would have known about it. But his consciousness was beating him up. Ya Rasulullah, what do I do? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to him, do you have enough of money to set free a slave? He says, no, I don't. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to him, then can you fast 60 days consecutively? Kafara. The man says, no, I can't. And in some narrations, the man said, it was the fast which got me into the problem in the first place. So now you're asking me to fast another 60? I mean, already this was more than enough. Then the Prophet ﷺ said to him, can you feed 60 people? He says, I've got nothing to give anyone. I don't have anything to give anyone. Khalas. Now what do we do? After some time, someone had brought the Prophet ﷺ this large dish full of dates. And so the Prophet ﷺ said to the man, here, you know, you were lucky, take these dates and give it to the poor here in Medina, Al-Munawwara, feed 60 poor people. Then the man says, Ya Rasulullah, is there any house in Medina, Al-Munawwara, which is more poor than my family? We are the poorest in Medina. Prophet ﷺ said to him, smiled, and then said to him, take the dates and feed your family. And so the man left. Subhanallah. Look at Nabiul Rahmah. On a side story, look at this man. He comes, I've destroyed myself. What did he do? The major sin. There's nothing else besides this here, sleeping with your wife in the month of Ramadan, which dictates the kafara, except this, the severe kafara. The man has fallen into that major, major sin. What's the kafara? Prophet said, number one, number two, number three. Eventually, this man leaves. He goes back to his house, and he's got all of these dates for himself and his wife to suffice them for 60 people. Imagine his wife, she might have been sitting there thinking, what's gonna happen? Are they gonna kick us out of Medina? What's gonna happen? What penalty, what punishment? Husband comes home smiling, he's got all of these dates. What happened? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave this for us. It's like as if they were rewarded. Allahu musta'an. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was seated in the last few days of his life. Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha was with him. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said something to her in her ears, which made her tear. And then he said something to her and it made her smile. Hadith reported by Imam al-Bukhari. Later on, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had passed away, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha asks Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, what did the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam say to you that made you tear? And what did he say to you which made you smile? And so Fatima said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my father. And we know that Fatima passed away how long after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? 6 months after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she passed away. And we know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, Fatima bada'atun minni. Fatima is a portion of me. She's a part and parcel of me. Whatever angers her, angers me. This daughter, most beloved of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to her that Jibreel comes down every Ramadan and revises the Quran with me. And this year, he's come and he's revised the Quran with me twice. And so I feel that this means that this is my final Ramadan and I'm going to pass away very, very soon. And that's why she teared. And then he said what to her? And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to her that you will be the first of my family members to meet up and to be joined up with me. And she passed away 6 months later after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so the point here was that people would come and ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam questions. They would have issues, they would have problems. People would come with zakah questions. We know that Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, he would say to the people when he was the Khalifa that this is the month of your zakah. We know that we fast. And many a person, you know, they pay their zakah in this month. And so he gave the rulings, the issues with regards to zakah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with regards to the noble Quran. And so we know that in this month, he got his first revelation. He was bestowed with prophethood in this month, the 27th of Ramadan. Where was he? He was in the cave. Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, better than 1,000 months. Some of the scholars stated that because the people of the past, they would live for years and years, over hundreds of years, like Adam alayhi salam, etc. More than hundreds of years, their lifespan was. And so how could it be that the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who's a better ummah, how could it be that the average lifespan is between what? What's the average lifespan? 62, 70, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. You live more than that, that's a bonus, inshallah. Jayid. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was given the gift of Laylatul Qadr, better than 1,000 months. Many a scholar would say that this month, it'amu ta'am wa tilawatul Qur'an. It's the month of feeding the people and it's the month of recitation of the Qur'an. Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, he would recite the Qur'an. Imam Malik would leave away all of the durus, all of the lessons, and only concentrate on the noble Qur'an. Imam al-Shafi'i would make 60 khatams of the noble Qur'an in the month of Ramadan. And we know that these stories, etc., we'd say, well, that was Imam al-Shafi'i, that was Abu Bakr, that was Umar, they were great companions, etc. I'm in a blue chip company, I'm working a desk job, how am I able to do all of that? Yes, you might not be able to do that, but, and it's understandable for them, but think on this point, that if you are in school, if you're in business, you sell cars, whatever, and you make an effort to even recite one juz of the Quran a day. You have so many engagements here, there, and everywhere, but you make that effort to read one juz or two juz or one para, in comparison to Imam al-Shafi'i who had his suhoor in the morning and he had nothing else to do for the rest of the day except answer questions and these things. In comparison, subhanAllah, you have a lot of engagements, and so that little effort that you might put in, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, might equal what many of the great scholars of the past used to do. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would spend his day like this. Then the time of Zuhr comes upon him and he's in the masjid for Salatul Jama'ah. Maybe after Salatul Zuhr, a qaylula. What's a qaylula? Qaylula is an afternoon nap. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, aqilu fa inna shaytan la yaqil. Take this afternoon nap, this power nap, for verily shaytan does not take this nap. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues his day, advising people. He states sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whoever fasts, and it does not prevent him from speaking lies and talking nonsense and engaging in all of haram, then there's no point in his fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of this person being thirsty. Allah is not in need of this person staying away from food. What was the point? There was no point. Imagine the Muslim, and many a Muslim we have, Allahu musta'an, that the month of Ramadan comes upon him, fasting, walhamdulillah. But as for salah, then there's ma fi salah. Salat al-Tarawih for the first few nights, and then it's finished. You don't even see the man in the masjid. Allahu musta'an. What's more important, Ya Abdullah? Salah or fasting? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, Al-ahd alladhi baynana wa baynahumu salah faman tarakaha faqad kafar. The difference between us and them is the leaving off of the salah. And whoever leaves it, abandons it, then this person's fallen into the other category, which is the category of kufr. Allahu musta'an. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the mimbar, he takes a step down, he says ameen. Another step down, ameen. People asked him, what were you saying this ameen? What was this? You never did this before. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Jibreel came down and he made a dua and I said ameen. Whose dua? Jibreel. Whose ameen? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You think the dua would not go accepted? It definitely would be accepted. What was one of those matters? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said ameen to Jibreel, saying that woe to that person that Ramadan comes upon him and he does not earn his Jannah. Ramadan comes upon this person and he did not sow the good seeds for him to reap the rewards in the hereafter. Allahu musta'an. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would come to him and ask him about the issues of zakah. We know that this is the month of zakah. And at that time, no doubt, you had the issues of sheep, you had the issues of cows and camels, and you had currency, gold and silver. But in comparison to today, the issues of zakah are massive, subhanAllah. You have people with long-term debts, you have people with short-term debt, you have shares, you have the share trader, you have those who have investments. How do we pay zakah in all of these matters? Many a books you find minus your debts. But what if I have debts of 2 million over 20 years? Do I minus long-term debts? No, you don't minus long-term debts. You only minus those debts which are there, if it's a long-term debt, which is due upon you for the next 12 months. And what if you have assets, monies which are due to you? Someone owes you 10 million. This is an asset. Do you pay zakah on 10 million? Good if you did, but you're not obliged to. What you're obliged to do is only the 12 months which you expect to get money for the next 12 months, that's what you pay upon. And a million issues with regards to zakah. Come the time of Salatul Asr, you find even up till today, walhamdulillah, many a Muslim, after Salatul Asr, you find him in the masjid. During the week, he might be working. Saturday and Sunday, he's in the masjid. And so between Salatul Asr and Maghrib, and you find the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they would sit there, and many a times if their own kids were also fasting, they would bring some sort of toy for the kid and have the kid play with it to remove the kid's mind from the food, keep the kid busy with something. And then the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum would protect their fast by sitting in the masjid. Come the time of Salatul Maghrib, Iftar, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, that the believer, he has these two times of happiness. Number one, at the time of Iftar, and number two, the day of Eid. And so the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his sunnah was to break his fast with tamar, with rutab rather. Tamar is dried dates, rutab are the fresh dates. So he would have some of these rutab and break his fast. Also, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say that this is the time for dua. This is the time when dua is accepted. Also, this month of Ramadan, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, if one looks back in history, you find great intisarat happened with the Muslims in this month. Great victories. The battle of what was in this month? The battle of Badr was in this month. The great battle of Badr. Also, the conquest of Makkah. Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, imagine Ya Abdullah, he left Makkah al-Mukarramah. In the evening, night time, he was hiding because he was hunted. And he left in the state of darkness, fear. He goes off to the cave, hides there for some time, then makes his way to Medina. A few years later, he is the conqueror of Makkah al-Mukarramah. But he lowers his head. Why? Out of tawadu, out of humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This also occurred in the month of Ramadan. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, you know our brothers and sisters who are suffering in Syria. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this month of Ramadan, insha'Allah, the next few days, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, that the butcher Asad will be sorted out, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Allahumma musta'an.
How many a Jum'ah we go to? How many a khutbah we hear? But we don't even hear people talking about our brothers and sisters, what's happening in Syria. And our brothers and sisters in Burma, Allah musta'an. So this is the time, this is the month, wherein we remember all of them, because we are only but one ummah. As we mentioned here previously, you might have an Arab brother, you have a Palestinian brother, you have an African brother, a Nigerian brother. What's the link which joins all of us? Nothing but La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam breaks his fast, Salatul Maghrib, later on the time for Salatul Isha, and we know that he would say, Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Whoever stands the month of Ramadan in prayer, then his past sins are forgiven. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, out of shafaqah for this ummah, he prayed Salatul Taraweeh for only 3 or 4 nights. And he feared that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would love it so much and make it an obligation upon us, so he stopped. But he would pray on his own. Sahaba would pray on their own. Later on, during the time of Umar, Umar renewed and brought back this practice of Salatul Taraweeh in Jama'ah. The debate should not be the amount of rak'ahs, rather it should concentrate on the quality. What was the quality of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's prayer? This is not the month where we're supposed to be fighting and having moon fighting like other countries, etc. Jayid, we have moon sighting in South Africa, they have moon fighting in the UK. Jayid. So this is not the month wherein we're supposed to be fighting, etc. But rather this is the month, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, where we ponder over the past year, where time has gone, and we make a renewed effort, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, that this month of Ramadan, this Ramadan here, is going to be a different Ramadan. This kalam of Allah, have I read it? Have I understood this kalam of Allah? Any other book, any instruction manual, I'll read it, I want to know what's happening. I want to buy shares, I'll check out Anglo Gold and this one and that one, and I'll be a master in that. What about kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What about the kalam which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given a message to every single one of us? Hayyakum Allah, jazakum Allah khairan. Hada wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala amdihi wa rasulihi nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum.